I'm going to quickly run through some of the main editing features on our mobile app because they're really incredible. And there's a couple that are a little hidden that I find people don't always know about. So I'm going to start off with the slash editor. If I hit that on the left here, you see it pulls up this editing menu. And by the way, you can also type the slash, but I think it's easier just to hit the button there. And here I can do everything from, you know, add a heading, I can add a task, different lists, a checklist, quotes, backlink, which there's some shortcuts for these in here on the editing menu, by the way. I can type now. That's actually one not many people know, and it'll include the time there. That's kind of cool. And then if you saw on the bottom, there is all of my templates that I have saved, my custom templates. So, you know, or not just the custom ones, all of them. So I could type company and that will include the company template there. So you can access all of that from the slash editor menu. Then the second one down here is the AI assistant. So if I have to type something first, so I'll just type my name in here as an example and hit that magic sparkle button or the magic stars. And here I have all of the AI prompts. I've got the system prompts that come with Reflect down here at the bottom. And up top are all of my custom ones. So you can run all of your prompts directly within the mobile app. And cool. And then the next one is the checklist item. So I'll close out that there and I'll just push that. Or sorry, that was the bullet list. So yeah, I can hit that, create a bullet list and say, you know, list one and list item two. And you know, just create basic bullet lists. By the way, you can also kind of like highlight the text in here. You can select different items and then going on to the next one, let's say this first list item was actually a to-do list item or maybe an actual task, I can type the checklist item and it becomes a checklist. I hit that again, it becomes a task. So I don't know if you just saw there, it toggled between square and circle. I'll select that there for the task. You can see that it's purple. And for the checklist item, it's gray when you check it there. So you can add the different list items there. And by the way, the tasks items will show up on the tasks tab on the desktop. We're in the progress of moving these over to the iPhone. And what's next? Next is backlinking. So let's say I need to pull up a backlink and I'll just backlink Reflect. Just as an example there. There you go. That's a backlink. The next one is tag. So let's say I'm in a book note or something. So I'll book tag to it. This isn't a book, so I probably wouldn't do that, but easily add tags there. This next one is I would describe this one as slightly hidden in that some people don't know about it. These will allow you to push list items which I think is amazing because so many mobile apps make it really, really hard to do this, and this just makes it so clean. And in the similar line, if I scroll this menu editor to the side, similar functions that move them up and down. So this just makes lists so, so good and easy on the mobile app. The guys did such a good job on this. And then the last one here, or second to last one, I guess, if I want to add an image, I have no idea what's in my phone images, so I'm actually going to hit the image button. But if you tap that button, it'll just let you attach an image to a note. That's one that I get asked about a lot. And then finally on the menu editor here, this thing just punches the keyboard down. So if you're in a note and you just want to read the whole thing, you don't want that keyboard up, you can have it disappear. And if I click into it, it pulls the keyboard back up with all of this editor. So those are some of the basic editing functions on the mobile app. Really, really smooth. It makes using the mobile app an absolute joy. So definitely recommend practicing them and at least knowing that they're there so you can access them.